Hey everyone, it's Dr. Admin. We're back with more admin prep. Today we're going to cover workflow and process automation. In this section, it's all about automation. Two main things we're going to talk about today are flow and approval processes. We'll also cover some of the other automation tools that may or may not be on the test. First one up is the big deal alert. This is a automation process that sends out an email. It's only in opportunities. You specify the amount and the probability, and then you select who gets the email, and that's pretty much it. Big deal alert, only in opportunities. You need the amount, probability, you specify who's getting the email. The next topic we're going to talk about is workflow rules. This may not be on the test, but I'm going to cover it just in case. Essentially, you create a workflow rule to specify some type of criteria, and then you launch actions for it. In this scenario, we have our criteria. When the billing address equals true, simple criteria, I'm going to checkbox equals true, and we can specify the evaluation criteria of either when it's created, creating every time it's edited, creating any time it's edited to subsequently meet criteria. If one of those conditions is met, it goes ahead and fires one of these actions, which can either be make a task, send an email, update a field, you know, update the current record or the parent record, or send an outbound message. With workflow rules, you can also set up immediate action. So a workflow rule fires on save. Once a record is saved, it's going to fire the action if the criteria is met. Any of the immediate actions are going to fire right away. Any time dependent action, you can set up to tell it when you want to fire. So in this scenario, I have it set up for 30 days after the rule trigger date. So 30 days after that rule trigger date, it's going to fire my workflow rule if the criteria still is being met. One other thing is you can only have active 50 rules per object. If you use time dependent actions, you must designate a default user. This is so the user can get email if something goes wrong or limits are hit and the action cannot be queued. You can see all your pending rules in the workflow pending queue. Next tool on the list here is Process Builder. This may not be on the test, but with Process Builder, you can specify the name and then you can also specify how it starts. You see there can be when a record gets changed, that's edited or created, platform event, message received, or it's invoked by another process. So you can have a Process Builder call another Process Builder if you need. It's pretty similar to the workflow rules to specify the criteria. You can have different types of criteria within your Process Builder. You can specify the conditions are met. If the no evaluate the true or no criteria, just fire this action. So you can specify the conditions. With Process Builder, you have the ability to call a couple of different types of actions. So you have Apex, you can create a record, you can email, you can call flow, you can post things to Chatter, you can call other Process Builders, you can call a quick action, you can send things to Quip, you can send a custom notification, you can submit things for approval, you can also update records. So all these things you can do with Process Builder, but it's kind of a dying tool because flow's taking over a lot of these things already. So this may or may not be on the test, just pointing it out. This is a simple update with a Process Builder. So we're doing a field update. We're specifying the record. So we're specifying the contact that we're doing. We're specifying there's no criteria. We're just updating the business phone with the phone from the contact. Before we move on, please like, share, and subscribe. I do produce Salesforce tips every week. Next thing up is the approval process. This will be on the test. This is one of the categories. With approval processes, you set them on an object and you give it criteria. This is so somebody else can approve the record so that you can have verification. So it allows another eye to be on there and then you can have a documented process of saying, yes, this record was approved. Most commonly gets used on opportunities, but it can be used on other objects as well. When you set up your approval process, you have to give it a name, you can give it a description, you can specify entry criteria or not. Later on, we'll get into the different steps and how you can specify criteria there for as well. You can specify who can edit the record. You can say the administrator or the current approver or just the current approver as well. This just means that when it's being approved, the administrator can always come and modify the record, or the current approver can come in here and modify the record too. So that needs to happen during the approval process, but everybody else, the record is locked too. We have our approval assignment email template. So if you want an assigned email template, you can also use email actions later on to send emails out. So if you want to assign an email template right out of the gate, so when something gets assigned, you can use that template, and then the approval pulse template as well if you wanted that. So once something gets approved, you can use that template as well. You can use the actions to do that as well. The active status tells if it is active or not. You can also allow submitters to recall approval requests. So if this is checked, it means that if I submit something for approval and I change my mind, I can recall it. If it's not checked, once I submit something for approval, I have to wait for the approver to either approve or reject that approval process, that approval for that record. With the approval process, we have our initial submission actions. So once an approval process gets submitted, what do? Typically, we lock the record from being edited. We want to make sure that nothing's getting changed on this record while we go through the approval process because we want to approve what we know. And then we can set up our different steps. We have our first step here where we give it a name, but we just want to say if the opportunity is less than 500, we want to go here, else go to the next step. So if it's less than 500, we're going to do this step. If it's greater than 500, or greater than equal to, we're going to go to the next step. And we specify that if it's less than 500, I'm going to be the approver And if it's greater than 500, somebody else will be their approver. This isn't an ideal approval, but it's an approval nonetheless. Once it goes through all the steps, there are some approval actions that can take place. We have our final approver actions, our final reject actions, and our recall actions. It's important to note that the final approval actions, you can change the record lock. You can say it stays locked. Locked means that nobody can modify it. If it is unlocked, it means it can be modified again. Final rejection actions, typically you want to unlock the record so people can change the record. But there are cases where maybe you can only go through approval process once. If it gets rejected, then it has to stay in that status. And then also for the recall action, if you're going to recall something, you're probably going to want to unlock it. Otherwise, you can't modify the changes and make changes to the record to submit it again for approval. With approvals, you can unlock or lock a record. A reject typically unlocks, recall typically unlocks. With approval, you can lock or unlock the records. Locking just means that nobody else can modify except for the current approver. So all the actions that are possible with approval processes are email alerts, task creation, field updates, and outbound messages. These are all the same ones that you have in workflow rules. The next up here is flow. This is most commonly in what most of your test questions are probably gonna be on. Salesforce Flow is the product. Flow Builder is a tool that builds flows. Flow is the application that's using the automation. Within a flow, there are a couple different things. We have elements, connectors, and resources. Our elements are our get records, our screens, our decisions. Connectors are the things how we designate the path for our flow. And then our resources are other different fields and pick list values that we can select within the flow. There are a couple of different types of flow. There's screen flow, record trigger flow, schedule trigger flow, and platform events and auto launch. With a screen flow, allows a user interaction to take place. So you want to put this on a page and a user interacts with it. Record trigger flow works just like your workflow rules and process builders. It's looking for some type of action to occur when it's saved. And once it saves, it's going to go ahead and fire that. Record trigger flow can be before or after the save. So when you hit save, you can run a flow before it's saved. And you can also run a flow after it's saved. Scheduled trigger flows allows you to basically set up a schedule for when you want this flow to fire. So you can say, I want to fire this flow daily. I can want to specify however I want this flow to fire. So you can go find all the records that match the criteria and then run that flow for those particular records. Platform events, if you set platform events, if it's platform event is triggered by it, you can trigger a flow off of it to go do some type of action as well. And auto launch flows, there's no triggering point for this. It's just a flow that gets set up. Typically, they can be called by other record trigger flows or screen flows. You can also use Apex to call them as well. Just runs in the background, but there's nothing triggering it. So you have to specify the triggering mechanism to call that flow. This is a little sample flow of a screen. We have our start element. We have our screen one. We have our decision. If it's yes, we do this step. If it's no, or the default outcome will go down to the step. And then you can keep going down the line until we're done. That's all we have for admin prep. Thanks for sticking around, and I'll see you around.